Judging by the noise coming from the away dressing room before the match, City's players are not in the mood for change. Jose Mourinho can moan as much as he likes. David Silva's electric run continued with another two goals. David should have been bald forever. Tears of joy, tears of joy, tears of joy. What a player. Smiling face. Benjamin Mendy at Ben Mendy. 23 December 13, 2017. Pep Guardiola's team will keep turning up the volume of their music, continue to win football matches and carry on breaking records. A 15th successive Premier League win, and so breaking Arsenal's record across two seasons in 2002 was a formality as soon as Kevin De Bruyne made it 20 via a 34th-minute free kick. The away dressing room at the Liberty Stadium is next to the media's press conference room, and it was shaking to the sound of Wonderwall by Oasis an hour before the game. There was nothing wondrous about Swansea's Twoman Wall and City's team switch to cruise control on a night which also saw David Silva score a brace, making it 4 goals in 3 games. Sergio Aguero grabbed the fourth late on for their 52nd league goal of the season. David Silva was on the score sheet again. Kevin De Bruyne scored a wonderful free kick. Unsurprisingly, the comparisons will continue between City and Arsenal, and in particular Arsene Wenger's Invincibles team of 200,304 will continue. It remains unlikely whether this current team will be able to match that achievement, particularly if they are to go deep into the Champions League, but their football is just as good to watch. On current form, in terms of a title race, it looks as though the second half of this season could be null and void. City were not at their best last night, but they did not have to get out of second gear against a Swansea team whose spirits were lifted with a 10-0 win over West Brom. Goals of the round. Watch the best strikes from the midweek Premier League action. Sergio Aguero celebrates scoring against the Swans, but if the South Wales club do suffer relegation, and they are clearly in major trouble, their plight will not be decided by results against the champions elect. Their hopes rest on matches like the next two games when they face Everton and Crystal Palace, and Paul Clement needs at least one win if he is to keep his job. For City, they can now look forward to Saturday's home game against Spurs with even greater confidence, if that is actually possible after what has been an excellent few days for Guardiola. Interactive lineups. Click on a player's number below to see their stats. Interactive stats. Click on the categories to find out how the teams fared after annoying the hell out of Mourinho and beating Manchester United. They got back to the business of carving out a straightforward 3 points with Wilfried Bony not enjoying a good night against his former employers. Guardiola made 4 changes from the win over United, with Vincent Kompany joining John Stones in the physio room. Nicolas Otamendi and Eliaquim Mingala played together in central defence. In the past, throwing in Fabian Delph at left back, you would be worried about City's defence, but considering the number of teammates with stardust in their boots, life is pretty simple. Wilfried Bony gets involved in a tussle initially. City looked slightly off the pace, but Swansea never truly believed they could do anything, and that is a major plus. Some teams are beaten before they even enter the pitch against this outstanding team. The opening goal was slightly odd. Swansea's Roque Mesa lost possession with a terrible pass, Bernardo Silva's cross was decent enough, and David Silva was left completely unmarked. With the home defense hoping in vain for the offside flag, and Fabianski staying rooted to the spot rather than gambling and attacking the cross, the Spaniard stuck out his leg and guided the ball into the net. Fabianski dreaded another excellent save from Aguero and then got a whack on the head after making the save. Maybe he was a bit groggy, but he did not cover himself in glory when failing to get near De Bruyne's free kick, which took once bounce on its way into the net. The wall consisted of Mesa and Nathan Dyer, and it was, quite frankly, a complete waste of time, although De Bruyne's whipped effort looked more like a cross. Mikel Arteta was in the dugout following the fracas following the Manchester Derby midweek roundup. Watch the best action from the latest round of Premier League action. David Silva missed an open goal 45 seconds into the second half, but the visiting fans were once again chanting his name a few minutes later. He played Ionetwo with Raheem Sterling and then flicked the ball past Fabianski. Guardiola made some changes, giving Alexander Zinchenko his league debut and Yaya Toure only a seventh appearance of the season. Toure found Aguero with a simple pass before the Argentine striker ran rings around the visiting defense embarrassingly so and slotted the ball into the corner. So, approaching the halfway mark of the season, City still have a 100% away record and are now on 49 points. This amount would have seen them finish in the Premier League last term, but as we all know, there is only one place they will end up this season. The key is when they will be able to start playing "We Are the Champions" in their dressing room.